Hi guys! Today I want to teach you how to create your own branded ebook like this using Canva. To save you a bunch of time, I'm going to show you how to search for a suitable template, including an ebook cover page. I'm also going to show you how to search for a suitable template which has multiple pages to help you with the design process, including an index page. I'll also be sharing with you another Nikki Ninja tip, which will help you integrate two pages from two separate templates. All you need for this tutorial is a free Canva account. So let's get started. So to start off your ebook, you're going to find a suitable template. You can use these different categories right here, but I think when you're pressed for time, you just want to go straight to what you're looking for. So put your cursor in the search bar and just type magazine and click on magazine cover. Now this is slightly misleading. It implies that there's just one page, the magazine cover, but some of the templates do provide multiple pages. So here are all the Canva templates that are associated with magazine covers. And have a scroll through and have a look. But again, to save you a bit of time, you can just click on blank magazine cover. And then scroll down the left-hand side here and narrow down your search by using these subcategories. So you have a category for food magazines, teen magazines, travel, fashion, sports. Scrolling down, wedding magazine cover. I think I'm going to check these out, so I'm just going to click on the category heading here just to call up all the templates. And if I scroll down, I can see that there's a lovely variety. If there's a specific color that you want to incorporate in your magazine, just use the filter tools here and select your color and then apply filters. If you hover your mouse over a template, you'll see that if there is a little free icon at the bottom, that means that there's just one page and it is free. If you hover your mouse over a different template and it starts scrolling across, that means that that particular template has multiple pages. I like the look of this particular template, so I'm just going to click on it once to open it up. And clicking on it once will reveal all the pages within that template for you to have a closer look. You don't have to use all five pages in this template. To use just a couple of the pages, all you need to do is select each page individually to bring it up onto your desktop. Or click on Apply All Five Pages. Each magazine template is completely customizable, so you can change the font, the colour background, for instance, the photographs, everything about this template I can actually edit. I'm going to choose one of my own brand fonts by selecting the text, going up to the text pull-down menu, and clicking on one of my brand fonts. I'm going to customise the headings and the body text as well. It doesn't take very long, it's all done in just a few clicks. If you want to change a photograph, select it once, delete it, go over to the Photos tab, type in a couple of keywords in the search box to narrow down your search, such as weddings and flowers. See what that brings up. If you are going to be using photographs from the Canva library, make sure you're aware that some of these will be paid photographs. So this one is a pro photograph, this one is as well, and this one. So if you need to narrow down your search to the free photographs, click on the filter tool and select free and then apply filters. I'm a Canva pro, so I'm just going to leave that as it is. I really like this photograph, so I'm going to click on it once and drag it into my photo frame. Perfect. And since I've got a lighter background, I need to change the color of this text to, I think, probably a very dark green. Now, I don't know if you can see, but right at the bottom here is this really handy Canva power tool. And it's inviting me to change all instances of white to this green color. So if I click on this button, have a look and see what happens to this text. In an instant, in just one click, it will change it to the darker green colour,
all of it, so that saves you a load of time. Once you've finished customising your cover page, you can go through the rest of the pages and make similar adjustments. There's no quick way of changing the font styles, but it really shouldn't take too long. Now I need to change this particular heading here back to white because there's a dark background. So I'm going to do that. And do the same with this font as well. It's very quick. There we are. And my template's really starting to take shape now. I think I'm going to change this photograph here. Let me search on bride. See what that brings up. Oh, I really like this one. It's also free, so to place it inside my photo frame, I'm going to hold down my cursor and just drag it into the photo frame like that. Fabulous. So now I have an ebook cover, an index or contents page, an editor's note, and two separate magazine pages. Now here's a really neat trick for you. Let's just say you didn't like this contents page. Let me get rid of this for a second. Let's go back to our templates. Templates. And you prefer the contents page in this template. So here's what we can do. Let me get rid of this by selecting all the elements, clicking delete. And then I'm going to click on this particular contents page to bring it up onto this blank page instead. There's only one thing wrong with this. The visual style doesn't match our original template. However, I can put this right using another one of Canva's power tools. I'm going to quickly change the font in the heading so that it matches the others in the template. Now to quickly change the sections with a heading and a bit of body text, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the cover page. Let me just increase the size so you can see this better. I'm going to run my cursor over the heading and body text just to select them. I'm going to click on these three little dots here and select this roller brush. Now this is the copy style button. I'm going to click on it once. And you'll see that it's turned black. That means that it's loaded up with style like you would load up a roller brush with paint. Now scroll down to the page you want to change. And you're going to roll that roller brush over the first heading and body text you want to change, as if you're painting over the style. Make sure you hold your cursor down while you do that. Let go of the cursor. And the template style has been changed to match the previous pages. I'm going to run through that once more. You might have to tweak the text a little bit, but that's so much easier than having to go through manually and change every single instance of text. Fabulous, so now you know how to integrate a page from a completely different template into a template you're currently working on. And here is the completed, beautifully branded ebook.
That is it for this week's tutorial. Now you know how to create fabulously branded ebooks in Canva. If you'd like to learn more about how to use Canva for small business marketing, I'll leave a link in the description box below so you can check out my new Canva training packages. Book in for a free 30-minute chat with me so that we can discuss what you need. I've also got a whole playlist of Canva tips and tricks that you can watch, and I'll leave the link in the end screen, which is coming up in just a second. Thank you so much for watching again, and I will see you next time.